How's everybody doing today? Apologize if I yelled at any of you for peace bounding your weapon. I'm sorry, we're trying to keep it safe here, trying to be happy. And today we have a very special guest. I'm sure a lot of you came here to see him. Okay, he's been in several different movies, just like with Mystery Men. He's been on TV, he's been on a show called He Didn't Count. Tearing it up in ratings right now called Game Shakers. And what blew my mind, because I'm flipping through and I have the grace of having this man on my Instagram. I'm going through and I'm like, oh my God, guess who was just on Ellen? His name is Kel Mitchell.
Let's do it. Let's start.
I'm gonna ask everybody in the audience. First of all, younger people in the audience, do you know who Kel Mitchell is? You're older. Yeah, Kel Mitchell, the little girl, the pink and white over there. Great. Do you know who Kel Mitchell is? You do? Because I'll tell you, I thought I knew him until the last time we did together, and he's going through some of, his accolades. I should know all this stuff. I should have the freaking list in front of me, and he says to me, oh man, I was on Clifford, right? And I'm like, you're not Clifford. He's like, I was T-boning. I'm like, oh my God, I'm in front of all these people. You are. And then
Please do the T-boning, boys.
Please.
Be the best dog on your block.
I'm pretty sure the kids out with that.
So, a big thing that people are always wondering, and we talk about all the time, is how you got into the industry.
How did I get into the industry? I'm from the south side of Chicago.
Yeah.
And I got into theater. I started acting in a lot of different plays. Doing that, and I just fell in love with the art of acting. It was a way, it was a hobby. It was a good thing to do and not get in trouble in the streets and stuff like that. And then my first gig was I modeled for Captain Crunch. So I was the model first.
Super long, even get over this time. What? Look at him.
Supermodel. I was on the back of Crunch Barrel. And it was crazy. My neighborhood was living at it. They're like, oh, Kel's a big fan of everybody.
Awesome.
And then after that, I started auditioning even more. And for me, it was just, I was a theater kid. So I just enjoyed doing plays. But then I got an agent for one of my plays. I was going downtown and started going on different auditions and commercials and stuff like that. And I was in a Subway commercial, which you think you probably missed me way back then. But then after that, Good Burger came up. Not Good Burger, but All That came up. They did a nationwide search for the kids, and it was a great audition process. I think the first audition was pretty crazy because I was there late. And I knocked over a couple of the camera cords in there, so I thought I didn't get it at all. It was just hilarious. But I kind of played it off as a physical comedy, and they were like, oh yeah, that's funny. And I remember I got up there, and I had finals that day in school, and I forgot my monologue. I never do that, right? And they were like, you want to go out and practice it? So I practiced it, came back in, and then I did a whole bunch of characters. Ed was made up in there. Coach Creed, because that's based on one of my coaches. And I'm like, crazy children, what's wrong with that? And I was like, well, dude, how are you? All that. And I did all those things, and then I had a call back to go to Los Angeles. Like 2 weeks went by, and then it was a phone call. I remember I was praying and going to bed at night, and then I heard my mom answer the phone, and she was like, And then we went to, and then she's like, we're going to LA. And we flew out to LA to audition again, and this whole slew of other kids. But I beat them all out, that's for sure. Yeah. Okay, the older people in the audience.
Okay, look at them. They're all like, some of you might get this. I think this might, you know. There's a term in the acting world that is starting to make a comeback that kind of disappeared for a long time. It's called a triple threat. Now, triple threat is somebody who could act, who could sing, and who could dance. And that kind of like disappeared, because then you had, you know, you had your people that are like, okay, those are dancers, and that person can sing, but they can't act. And then Kel Mitchell was born and he came back. This man right here has, you do rap, you do a little singing, right?
Yeah, I rap, I sing. Every movie I was in, I tried to do something with the soundtrack. With Mystery Man, we were on the soundtrack after that movie with Ben Stiller and Jimmy Garoppolo. Had one of the title songs on there, which is pretty cool. Yeah, on the DVD, if you go to the special features of Missing Man, you'll see a music video with me and Brad Woods from back in the day. And then, Clifford the Big Red Dog, I did a title song on there, I wrote a song on there. And then on Game Shakers, I play a rapper, so for the young kids. So we do a lot of original music on there too as well, so yeah, it's been fun.
Now, I've seen you all over social media. I don't know, do you guys follow Cal? Yeah, if you don't, you collect yourself with great names.
I am Kel Mitchell.
Follow me on Twitter, Instagram. I picked this man up in the airport. We're driving, and it's like, he's always real social, great guy. And I say to him, I'm mad at you. Wow, are you mad at me, brother? And I'm like, I'm on my Instagram, and at like midnight, this dude is doing these like workouts, and I'm like, seriously, you gotta watch him. He is physically fit. It's amazing. Just in general, everybody's always like, obesity. I see that you working out. It's like you're always promoting good lifestyle.
Oh, yeah.
I feel about that. I mean,
man, I'm all about it, man. To be on the Kids Network all these years, and I'm all about, you know, kids being healthy and working out, and then adults being healthy, too. Us too. You know what I mean? So, I go to the, you know, Trader Joe's and Whole Foods. Okay, so. Yeah, we go there and, you know, try to eat right and cook the right food, and then I work out every morning. My trainer meet up at like 4 a.m. and we work out.
I like pizza.
I like pizza too.
Want to take some questions?
Yeah. Feel free, we're family. Just have fun. It's fun.
All right. Let's get a single file line. If anybody wants to ask Kel Mitchell a question, get over here.
Why don't you just do it pretty soon? Oh, yeah. Oh, wait, my job.
Who's this? Why is everybody scared?
I'm just kidding.
There he is!
Really Random Rants!
That's what the shirt says.
It's like YouTube show.
Awesome.
You once did a poem about orange soda. Did you say that now?
I don't know if I even remember that. I remember it was a Shakespeare one, and I was like, who loving or so it? They'll love it or so it. Is it true it? Is it true it? I do it, I do it, I do it.
Little brother's huge fan.
Tell him I said what's up.
Not only is it here, my little brother's a huge fan.
Oh, tell him I said hi. Definitely. What's up, little brother? I'll be safe. Hey, little brother.
Braden.
Hey, Braden. What's up, Braden?
I just had a request. I was wondering if you could sing for us, I'm a dude, she's a dude.
It's time to put our ties behind, get all the bad things off your mind. He's doing good, you doing good, we're doing good, yeah.
We're all good.
exist. A smile on your face and you can't erase it. Partying on to the break of dawn. Partying on to the break of dawn. Go! How fun is it in my own movie? It's a lot of fun. I have fun working on the show, and it's great to make people laugh like yourself and put a smile on your face. I love doing that type of stuff.
Another one?
You
got it? Go ahead.
And, I forget what episode it was, but
okay.
Why does she really, really care about that woman that she
had?
I forget her name.
Oh, Maddie on the show. He's talking about Game Shakers, and one of the kids on the show, she has a pet rat, so that she found on the subway. So she loves animals, Matt. She loves animals. You love animals? Yeah, she loves all kind of animals, even the sewer.
I have a family
that. Oh, really? Michelle Jasper, I said hi.
You got it?
Repair that, I'm
ready. What's good work you
happening? Oh! I will tell you this, it's Hashman Talks. So, you know, the key is ready, I'm ready, so we're just talking to the powers that be. You know, we'll make it happen. The fans wanted to happen. Keenan and I, when we did Jimmy Salas and Jimmy, you know, we talked about we got to do something. So we got a couple projects we're working on together, so we might see a lot of them.
So I saw your backpack there. I was wondering, which Nicktoons is your favorite?
Oh, wow. I have to go with Ren and Stimpy, first of all. I like crazy characters, you know what I mean? If you notice my characters a little wild. So I definitely like Ren and Stimpy, yeah.
Thank you, man.
Back.
My mom's
back. Sorry,
you
like orange
soda.
Kill the orange soda.
Random questions to get your face. Dance food?
Dance food.
Right? Yeah. What's up with that? Explain it.
Dance food is that was a movie I did a couple of years back. It's a movie that I wrote. It's starring me, Serafina Tanner, and Tommy Davidson. It's about a guy that can only fight when music is playing. Pretty funny. It's a kung fu movie mixed with dancing, so it's like You Got Served meets Last Dragon. So you gotta check it out. That's pretty funny. Yeah. Yo.
Okay, go, go.
All right.
He's one of mine. That's why.
Oh, okay.
I have two questions. One, what do you think your favorite memory is from working on Nickelodeon, working with all of the guys there? Like, your favorite acting moment or just like off-screen moment?
I would definitely say, on all that, we have a lot of great music acts. So, like, being able to work with TLC and hang out with, you know, TLC, Aaliyah, and seeing Usher for the first time, like, you know, he was a new artist at that point.
Yeah.
A lot of the kids that came on our show, they were kids too, like, they were just starting out and stuff like that. So, that was fun because we used to hang out with him after. So, and we shot in Florida first on the Universal Studios line.
Mm-hmm.
So, we used to go hang out with a lot of musical guests and go ride back to future rides and between shots and stuff like that. So that was always cool to kind of have like our backdrop or our backyard be Universal Studios, you know, as a kid. So that was just like a really memorable time.
And my other question is, I mean, you've as a kid, and then, you know, you did a couple gigs here and there, but kind of like, you know, not fizzled, but like kind of went and did your own thing for a while, and now you're kind of like making this comeback, and I'm just wondering, like, what do you see yourself accomplishing in the next, like, 20 years? Like, where do you see yourself, like, taking?
Okay, guys, I want to start a campaign right now on the spot. So again, another one I was talking about, Kel. I'm like, when am I going to see you in a superhero movie? Why don't you start adding, you know, the DC Universe and Marvel Universe and hashtag got Kel?
Yes!
Start doing it randomly and see what happens. Maybe we can get something going.
You know?
I think it'd be awesome.
They need another static, they need a static shot movie.
I got it.
Hey!
I have sort of a long question.
Okay.
You started at only bleeding as a child.
Yes.
And then you returned as an adult.
Yeah.
And I watched both. And you described how you're able to express yourself as a child. And I'm curious if you're still able to express yourself the same as an adult, or is it more restricted as an adult? And what's been different for you as a child versus as an adult?
Well, I would say as a child, you know, you look at it, you come into it where it's like this amazing job that you have, but you don't look at it as a job. You look at it like, you know, at first. Well, for me it was. You know what I mean? And then as you get into being an adult, you kind of look at it as, oh, this is just this is cool. This is a job. You can separate the two. You know what I mean? I think as far as the fun and the blessing out of it, that's the same. You know what I mean? As far as like making people laugh and encouraging other kids to have those opportunities. Like, for me, it's a blessing to be able to give advice to the kids that are on game shows because I've been through it. You know, I didn't really have that on all that Akeem and Carol, where I had someone that can really give that advice and stuff like that. So it's been awesome to have them come up to me like, so Carol, what did you do when you were this age and this happened and like this? And so I feel like everything happens for a reason, and I'm there on that set to be that Uncle Carol for them, you know what I mean? Yeah. No problem. I love your dog. Your dog is awesome.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome, Keith Forney. Please come to the box office. Keith Forney, please come to the box office.
Okay.
All right.
The box office.
Overrated.
What's your favorite skit from all that?
Not Keith and Kill. All that. Coach Reed. Just because he's insane and he's missing a tooth and at the ball head, I can scream at the kids and fall on the floor and do a lot of great business. So I would say that. And of course, you know, that just took over and we had awesome guests that were coming on and we'd be in the good burger at our restaurant. So that was awesome too, you know. Yeah.
Let me, what? I was asking if you have a better angle.
First off.
I might.
First off, welcome back.
Thank you.
Thank you,
brother.
You've done so much stuff on Nickelodeon.
Yeah.
A lot of people know you from there. But
yeah.
You've also done so much stuff not involving.
Yeah.
In that regard, is there anything that like really sticks out to you that you've done originally?
further, or you just really wish you could like really focus on more, or just in general liked, and you will never forget how time you get.
It's really seen from, it's funny because people like they'll look at it going like, oh, it's just kids and things like that. And like I went back to the network and it's like, why does he do some adult stuff or do something like that? For me, it's all entertainment, you know, and it's family entertainment. And as long as I'm making people laugh and crack up, I'm all about it. You know what I mean? I've done Adult Swim and you know other shows and just all kind of fun stuff. But it's like I just enjoy every like all of it. You know what I mean? I've done drama, I've done action film. I'm working on, you know what I mean? So I take the experience from every part of it, you know what I mean? So it's a great experience, it's a career, you know what I mean? You just enjoy all of it.
Good.
Thank you.
Good.
Thank you, man.
Yeah. Hey. Yeah. First I'll add, Brett, put the hand here. You're alive with the Decepticons, but you're also badge work with security. I'm starting to question your allegiance here.
More than these guys.
My question to Cal though is, you got to try so many different things that you've done acting, you're doing singing, music, you just had to stand up and now you got to try your hand at directing and your production. Yeah. What do you think is your favorite facet of George?
I really like, you know, I like being on camera and off camera, man, but it's really something in writing, though. Like, I love writing. I'm a script writer as well. So, I mean, that's awesome to write something, come up with this amazing idea, God gives me, and then to write it, and then after that, see that come to life, you know, whether it be on stage or on television, and someone is, like, sitting there acting those words that you took the time to write. That's fun to me, you know what I mean? Like,
but thank you. Like as a kid, like you were one of the ones that really like seemed to bring that physical comedy back into like mainstream entertainment. It's an amazing
trip. Yeah, man. There you go. Yeah, comedy.
Hey, you just said you were talking about you'd like writing and all that. Have you ever thought of writing a book?
Yeah, that's awesome. I've got so many people that ask me about that, and
I need to. If you were to write a book, I would buy it.
Thank you.
This is my first Comic Con.
Hey.
First Comic Con, and I just met Gauss today.
Great guy.
I was pronouncing it right.
Great guy.
And now I'm meeting you. Today has been the best day ever.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Speaking of a Blue Ranger, did you meet him in a flight?
No comment.
If it was a movie, I was the Orange Ranger. We just kept it going. I was like, I don't know what's going on. And they wrote us up as two old men. Just
I was wondering, like, in the acting business and stuff, I know it can get really crazy. Sometimes I've heard stories of, like, people can lose themselves, you know what I mean? So I was wondering, what are, like, three things that you, or just some things that you have done to, like, keep from not losing yourself and just keep it, you know what I mean?
It would definitely be first and foremost, thank you, God. I'm a Christian. All about that. In this business, definitely needed prayer. Definitely works to have that clarity in the right direction on where to go. It's a lot of people in this business, everyone's out for your best interest. So to have that discernment on who's right to work with and who's right to be around you works. And a lot of actors, they get upset not just because they don't get the role, but what you don't know is that certain producers, certain writers have the person that they're looking for already. So if you understand that, then the job that's for you will come to you, and you just have to pray for it, and sometimes you got faith that it will work out. The other thing is consistency.
True.
Always consistency. You know, wake up, work on your craft. You know, like you was talking about me working out and stuff like that. If I'm saying I'm going to be an action film, then hey, I got to work for it.
Right.
You know what I mean? It's like if you want a new car, act like you got the car already. That's that faith. You know what I mean? Clean up your garage and get ready for it. You gotta think of that same way in your career as well. You know, be ready for it, prepare for it, like a boxer. You know, learn every aspect. And then the other thing is like, be your best fan. You know what I mean? You know, root yourself on promotion. Use every promotional tool that you can use. You have so many websites now, like Instagram and Twitter and all those things. I mean, promote yourself. Act for something, promote it, and people can see it. Because now, you know, many people are watching all over the world through social media. So that would be the next thing.
Your ears move. I was just wondering. Are those those moving ones? Oh, there.
Oh, she's got it. Look at it.
And also, at Kel Mitchell, follow him.
That's cool.
You have stuff so
cool. All right. Anybody else?
What are your musical influences? My musical influences? Oh man, I love jazz. I love, you know, like Miles Davis. I like a lot of new guys. I like EDM music as well. Yeah, Miles and all those guys, you know what I mean? I like Christian hip hop. You know, even hip hop as well. Like Chance the Rapper, you know what I mean? Common, you know, I'm from Chicago, so I like all my Chicago people. You know, so yeah, man, I like a big mix of rock and everything, man.
Who would you like to work with the next?
Who would I like to work with?
Yeah.
As far as music?
Yeah, if you could have like one artist like, doing a track or sample on one of your tracks.
Probably Kanye, man. Music video all falls down, and so that was a fun video, man. He's a nice guy, man, so that would be fun. And then who else, man? Busta Rhymes, I got to rap with Busta on the stage, you know, doing all that, because it was cool. Like, we got to meet a lot of these guys and freestyle with them and stuff like that, so yeah, man.
What about
Sinbad? Sinbad's still doing comedy, man. He's still doing stand-up and everything. He's a great guy, man. That was a fun dude to work with. Like, Sinbad, Shaq, all of them. Look him up Sinbad. He said, look at that. Look him up. He's fun.
Look up Sinbad.
Yeah.
You're right. You're right. It'll make you want to wear a windbreaker. I'm telling you. Oh,
yeah. All right.
So you mentioned that, like, kind of in your auditions, like, that's where kind of Ed and Coach Green emerge.
Yeah.
Like, so, when working with Nickelodeon, do they kind of give you guys more of, like, you get to give your impression of a character, and, like, that's what they go with? Or is it they write it and kind of basically
Represent that? It was like they allowed me to create the character. So with Ed, it just was written. You know, a little kid that would be like, well, together, you know, type thing. But it needed something. And I remember I went to the wig room and I saw these like really familiar brandy I want to be down with. I put that on. fun, and then the voice too as well. It just kind of let us do that. And then even with Coach Reed, it was the same thing. And even Jupiter, like that was like, love the room. It was like I was in a scene and all I was supposed to say is Jupiter. And I was like, he's up. So I just grabbed the wig and I was like,
Jupiter!
And it
took like,
and it blew up and it became a crazy character.
Real quick follow up to that then, if what do you think was there ever one where you had that was favorite where like the actor, not the actor, the writers didn't agree with it, but it was like that's not what we were thinking, but do that again.
No. I wanted to, I'm trying to think if there was a voice or something that did hear like that just didn't mark. But no. That's pretty good though. I'm glad it did. I was probably devastated. Like I did some right voice. Like no.
I bet like
Rick
Dixon
won't
take a song they like.
Oh, different one they wrote. Oh yeah. I mean like with Bill Burr, because originally it was Josh Server had this sketch called Dream Remote.
And from there, that kind of like took off Ed, we thought of Ed in that way. So it was a thing when they weren't even thinking about it. And then they were like, yo, let's get Ed the Good Burger guy. You know?
Awesome.
Because he could have been Ed the Pizza guy. That's a bit weird, but you know, it's not the same with pizza. Welcome to Pizza.
Welcome to Olive Garden.
I'm a big fan. I grew up watching, especially when all that and Team Intel first came on. So.
Thank you, bro.
Awesome.
Yeah.
But,
oh,
is there a special moment during all that, or teenage, so not necessarily skin-wise, that meant a lot to you, either advice or meeting somebody or anything of that nature? Maybe you hate corn soup and
actually, I like grape soda. That's the things they prefer. Okay. Figured out that we were going to start like doing more sketches together, and it was the moment where the writers figured it out and they started putting out some more stuff. It was like I was basically playing the sketch and we were kind of finishing each other's words and kind of just he got the exact way he was about to play. And it was just that moment where we kind of knew like, okay, we're going to be doing stuff.
So you pretty much flipped and came to that name.
That's right. We had superhero powers together. Take over the comedy world. Yeah. No problem, bro. What's up?
First of all, big time fan.
Thank you.
Saw it in Burger and Theaters today, came out.
Thank you.
Yeah. But I guess this is probably maybe a little complex.
Sorry, let's keep
being. But yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm an artist on the smallest scale, and I do a lot of traveling, and I've noticed, especially this kind of crowd, that they're the most beautiful, extraordinary people on the planet, and they're so full of love and kindness. But when they, and you can see that, when you all get together, you know, you come together, and it's this beautiful explosion of awesome.
Yeah.
But when they go out back into the real world, it can be quite a challenge. And especially to constantly being, you know.
Yeah.
So how would you, what advice would you have to keep them motivated and full of passion and love what they have?
Commanding your own.
Okay.
You have to be the light and the energy for other people. Don't allow negativity to take you down. Like literally walk in a room, and no matter what the negativity is, you walk in there as happy as you can be. And don't respond to anything. You know what I mean? You walk in, you can change a room and you can change people's whole perspective by the way you act. Like if you think about it in a way like what you just told me, and you go like, oh man, but when I get out here, it's gonna be crazy. So we're already having that anxiety.
Just talking about it.
But words have power. So just say, I'm gonna go out here, I'll be a light, everybody's gonna like me,
people
are gonna have fun, and someone's gonna get happy just by seeing my happiness. And you say that, and you walk out there, and you push that out there, like, make yourself happy. You know what I mean? Then everybody around you is gratitude.
That's
awesome.
Thank you. Definitely.
No problem.
Thank
no
you.
Problem.
Thank you.
What's up, man?
I
I love a good burger. I saw that a couple of weeks in school. It was like summer break, and I'd like to see you promote some of your shows.
Thank you.
About the superhero question, if you would be a superhero movie, what superhero or villain would you see yourself play?
Static Shock was the only one. And then, you know, doing something in the Marvel Universe would be pretty crazy. You know what I mean? So, yeah, man, I'm all about it. You know, I have been in there and talked to a couple of studios. You know what I mean? So, we're going to make something happen. You know, secure what you're doing over here. Melody's Comic-Con. Any other questions? Yeah.
Attention, ladies and gentlemen. Will Keith Forney please come to the box office? Keith Forney, please come to the box office.
Come to the box office. It's a small little box.
What was your favorite episode of Keith's
My favorite episode of Keith's The Thanksgiving episode was pretty fun.
Yeah.
It was a turkey, it was a hot turkey. My hand got stuck in turkey. That was pretty crazy. Both sweater blues, when I ruined it.
The sweater?
I ruined the sweater, yeah, at the restaurant. That was pretty funny. That was a funny one. And my cat was in there. Like a hot second. He was there, and then they were like, you want to just sit in the back and be extra? He was like, oh, okay. You know what I mean? He's psychologist, he's not, but it was funny, so that was a call of him. Memorable. Oh, my dad's a psychologist. Yeah. Oh, yeah. My dad's a psychologist, my mom is a teacher, so it was pretty crazy. So I'll be expecting my mom again. My dad was going, how you feeling about this?
How do you feel about that going to your room?
Sit on the couch. Let me talk to
you. I just want to say, I think I speak for everyone here. Just keep doing this.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Stuff that you've worked with, was there anybody that you were starstruck by?
Oh, everybody. Oh, man, I still do that. I'm never like, oh, you know what I mean? I remember, it was a couple of funny ones. Like, I remember when I met Will Smith for the first time. Because I was a huge fan, because I like watched, yeah, I was just, when he was Fresh Prince of Bel Air. Yeah. Hey, we were for that, though, when he was just Fresh Prince of a rapper.
Oh, yeah.
I was on the show. Yeah, and so I remember I got to meet him and won his Kids' Choice Awards. And Keenan knew that I was a little nervous to meet him. And so he just put me on blast. Because Will was like really nice when he meet him. He's like, he's talking to everybody, hey, man, how you doing? And I was quiet because I was like, you know, Keenan's like, he's killing me nervous, he's standing here. But it was cool, like now, like every time I see Will, he's this awesome guy. He's giving me great advice too as well. Like I remember I was on the back for Hancock when he did that. I was getting into writing, getting just great advice on my writing and stuff like that. Just a great guy. You know what I mean? So that was fun. Who else did I think I was talking about? You know, back when you were a kid too, a lot of pressures, you know, that you had that came on there and performed. That was pretty crazy too. You know what I mean? Like, a lot of, you know, the groups that used to come on, like Leah and TLC, so that was pretty crazy, you know what I mean? You know, they have to go, hey, I'm a fan. So
yeah.
That would be awesome. Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, no problem.
Keep up the
good work. Thank you. Thank you.
So speaking previously about the stuff, the trouble you guys got into backstage and stuff like that, yeah. Did you and Keenan ever try and rephrase?
Well, the lady looking for the hat. Would the lady looking for the Hamilton poster please return to the vendor they found it?
The boss on the top.
Yeah.
Did you and Keenan try and like recreate or go out on the blue or like that opening and all that rap thing or something like that, trying to recreate or any of that?
Trying to recreate the all that opening? No, we didn't do that. We didn't try to recreate or anything like that. I mean, they did different openings for all that. That was pretty cool. Yeah, again, when they did the reboot of all that, remember that? With the all another group of kids and stuff like that.
The other question I had was, Steven sat actually as mad as he always was on the show. Or was he a natural?
Oh,
Steven,
mad like he is on the show?
No, his dad.
His dad? Oh, Ken Dorman?
Yeah.
Oh, no, Ken's awesome, man. Ken's hilarious. Like, he's a real cool dude, and like, he's never like really anything like that. We're still good friends now. He's a nice dude, he, yeah. He looks a little scary because we're tall and like, you know, the ball and all that stuff. You know he used to die in the dead, right? The original. The original, like, died in the dead. Died in the dead, he had an afro and he's kicking his eyes. You know what I was kidding for?